today I would like to introduce the MEXi mammalian expression system, which we have developed here at IBA. And I would like to start the webinar with a short poll to see which kind of expression systems you're actually using. So which HEC expression system do you use? The MEXi 293E system, the 293 EPNA 1-6 E system from the NRC Institute, the Freestyle 293 system, the XB 293 system, or the HEC 293T system. Okay, so 33% already using the MEXi system, then another 67% use the Freestyle system, and another third uses the HEC 293T system. No one is using the EPNA 6E system or the XB system. Then I have a second question to the audience. This is related to the purification. So how often do you have problems to purify your protein of interest from mammalian supernatants? Often, seldom, or never? So we see that many people have problems purifying their protein of interest from mammalian supernatants, and another third has never problems. And I think this is a very good result, as it's typical for many labs, and we made the experience by ourselves that there are some tag systems that have problems to be purified with mammalian expression systems. So let me begin the webinar with a very short story. When I write my thesis, there was another student in the lab, and his task was to identify some specific properties of a protein. He planned to spend 3 weeks for the production of his protein and for purification. And finally, when he comes to the end of his thesis, he finally spent 4 months for the production and purification of the protein. So there was not much time left to do the research he was really interested in. And as we see again from the poll, there are some researchers who have also problems with the purification, and then the time for the real interesting experiments is not so much. There are many applications where you need very much pure protein in very short time, for example, crystallization experiments, antibody screening, or protein-protein interaction studies. You can also use transient expressed proteins for in vivo studies or assay development, and generally when you use high throughput applications, it's very important to use a strategy which allows you an efficient purification, because you do not want to optimize a downstream process or the upstream process for each protein again. So one problem why we have often problems to purify proteins from mammalian supernatants is that products for up and downstream are developed independently. For example, you have a provider that offers an expression system providing very well expression and good protein yields. But once it comes to purification, only a minor part of the protein can be purified from the supernatants. We see expressions from grams to liter, but these data are made in octet systems and ELISA systems. But once you have purified your protein, you only have maybe a few milligrams of protein left. So one reason for that is that there are components in cultivation media that interfere with the downstream purification process. For example, biotin and media must be blocked in order to get a Strep-Tag purification, which is not a really big problem because we developed a biolog blocking solution that can be used to block free biotin. However, because biotin is very cheap, some mammalian media consist high concentrations of biotin, and therefore you need much biolog solution, which makes a purification process more expensive. Much more worse is a problem when it comes to histec purification. We knew that there are many mammalian media where you cannot purify your histec proteins efficiently from mammalian supernatants. One reason for that is that there are components in many mammalian media that interfere with the histec purification process. And furthermore, you often have impurities after histec purification because eukaryotic cells contain more host cell proteins with histidine residues, making the purification more challenging. Providers for histec purification matrices often suggest to do a dialyzer step or to perform a buffer exchange purification. But however, this again will cost much time and money, and it would be much more easier if you can directly purify from your supernatant. So when we looked to the portfolio of IBA, we realized that we had many products in place allowing you to come from your gene of interest to your protein of interest. We have a broad portfolio for vectors with different promoters and affinity tags that serve those terminus. And furthermore, for many expression hosts like insect cells, bacteria, mammalian cells, or yeast cells. Furthermore, we have a very powerful purification system with a Strep-Tactin system, which allows us to do a one-step purification. And usually we get yields of more than 95% with this system. And as mentioned before, using biolog solution, it's already compatible with mammalian expression. And finally, we can use a tag in the analytic, for example, in Western blot, ELISA, or SPR applications. However, there was a gap in this portfolio, and this was a mammalian expression. So we wanted to develop an affordable mammalian expression system, which has a very low biotin content in the media, in order to perfectly match the upstream process with the Strep-Tag downstream process, and therefore have a powerful system in place, which not has to be optimized on the side of a customer. Now let's have a more detailed look to the components of the MEXi system. The first component are the MEXi 293E cells. These cells are HECNA cells, 293E, and the EPNA gene works together with a PDSG vector system, which we will see on the next slide. The second component is a MEXi cultivation medium, which has some agents that prevent the cells from clocking. However, these agents prevent an effective PEI transfection, which is a very cost-efficient transfection method. Therefore, we also developed the transfection medium, which does not contain the substances, and therefore allows a PEI transfection. The cultivation media has a very low biotin content of only 120 microgram per liter, and the transfection medium does not contain any biotin. Taken together, this is a transient expression system which saves time and cost for protein production, and all its components are perfectly balanced to the Strep-Tag downstream purification. Now let's have a look to the vector. The PDSG vector is a small vector containing a CMFL promoter that controls the expression of your gene of interest. The CMFL promoter is a powerful promoter, especially for transient transfection. Furthermore, it has an origin of replication for E. coli and an ampicillin resistance gene in order to propagate the plasmid. And finally, it has an REP. This element is very important because together with the stably expressed EPNA gene of the MEXi cells, it allows an episomal replication of your plasmid in the cells. Because usually if you do a transient transfection, the plasmid is not incorporated into the chromosome, and therefore with every cell deviation, the plasmid is not replicated, leading to a dilution of plasmid. By using the REP, the plasmid is replicated, and therefore the dilution process is decreased in its rate. Furthermore, the REP has an enhancer function for the nuclear import of the plasmid and the transcription of the gene of interest. Very important, all elements on this vector are license-free because they do not contain any IP elements. So all elements in this vector are IP-free. Here we see the results of an experiment where we compared the expression in MEXi cells using a PDSG vector compared to a pcDNA3 vector, which is a very common vector. And you can compare both vectors. They are both controlled by a CMV promoter. However, the PDSG vector has an REP. And we transfected the cells with GFP. And as you can see that on this slide, we achieve very nice transfection efficiency with both plasmids, as expected. However, if we look to the mean fluorescence intensity, so the GFP expression, we can see a threefold higher expression rate when we use a PDSG vector compared to the PCDNA3 vector. And this is because of the enhanced function of the REP, which means you can use other vectors with the MEXi system. However, vectors containing an REP and especially the PDSG are much more suited and provides higher yields compared to vectors without an REP. Now here we see a cultivation of MEXi cells for more than 1 month. And the cells were splitted every 4 to 3 days to 300,000 cells per milliliter. And we can see over the time that the cultivation is very easy and that we get a very good cell growth, maintaining a very high viability. At 2 points of time here in this culture, we took some samples for transfection experiments. That's why the concentration decreases, because we added some fresh media. And interesting is that here we have a 5-day period without any subcultivation. And you see that the cells grow to very high density of over 6.5 million cells per milliliter during this time. And this is a problem for many expression systems, because cells which grow to such high densities very often have a decreased doubling rate after you start subcultivation again. But you can see quite nicely that here, once we started the subcultivation, the doubling time is comparable to the time before the cells grow to such high densities. However, transfection efficiency will be decreased during the first 1 or 2 weeks after cells grow to such high density, while you should cultivate the cells after such high densities for 1 or 2 weeks before you start transfection experiments. The mean generation time of the cell line is 25 hours, and the maximum cell density that we reach is 15 million cells per milliliter without any feeds. It's just a simple batch cultivation. Another very important factor is the stability of transfection efficiency. For this experiment, we compared the transfection efficiency of a cell cultivation with a very low passage of 34, and the transfection of cells which were in the 67th passage. We used the secreted alkaline phosphatase and the GFP again for this transfection experiments. And we can see that the yield of secreted alkaline phosphatase after purification is comparable between both experiments, and it's the same for the transfection efficiency and the GFP expression, which is shown by the mean fluorescence intensity. You can see that it's not a problem to use the cells for 30 passages and get still the same transfection results as you get at the beginning of the cultivation. Here's another experiment I would like to show you. Here we optimize the transfection process of the MEXi cells with a PEI transfection reagent. And we used a design of experiments and central composite design, and we tested the factors of the cell concentration, the DNA concentration, and the PEI concentration. You can see if you look to increasing cell densities that the optimum, the highest transfection rate measured by the GFP positive cells, is shifted to more DNA and more PEI, which is not unexpected. However, you can also see that the cell density has not a great impact on the transfection efficiency. If you look to the optimum here and go to the high density, you see that you only lose 10% by increasing the cell concentration. And you can also see that the DNA concentration has only a very, very low effect on the transfection efficiency, which makes the system very robust. However, you can see that PEI concentration is critical. We have a broad range from 4 to around about 5.5 milligram per liter, where you get very well transfection efficiencies. But once you get under 4 milligram per liter, you see that transfection efficiency drops rapidly. Therefore, it's important that when you use MEXi, that you check the best PEI concentration range from 4 milligram to 6 milligram per liters, because there exist many protocols for the pipe preparation and there exist different formulations of PEI. Here we use 25 kilodalton linear pi, and it makes sense to test your in-house pi solution to get very well transfection efficiency. We talked about problems of purification of proteins from mammalian supernatants, and here we have three examples of proteins we expressed in the MEXi system and purified us with our Strep-Tag system. We have, again, the secreted alkaline phosphatase. Here we produce 143 milligrams per liter, and you can see here a quite nice purity. The bioanalysis results showed us over 95% purity. Here we have a monoclonal antibody we have done for a customer with 100 milligrams per liter purified protein. And you can see here a high purity of both the heavy chain of the antibody and the light chain. And finally, here we have a product for a customer. It was a customer protein, which we expressed with over 300 milligrams per liter in a batch process without any feeds. And again, you can see here 100% purity after one-step purification with Strep-Tag, Strep-Tactin system. Now let's have a look to the workflow with a MEXi system. First of all, you clone your gene of interest into a PDSG vector, for example, with or without a secretion signal, depending on the fact if your gene of interest has a secretion signal or not. And then you take the cells from your cultivation, centrifuge them for at 100 to 300 G for 5 minutes, and resuspend the cells in MEXi transfection medium. Then you transfer the cells into an Erlenmeyer flask or another suspension flask and directly transfect the cells by adding 1.5 milligram per liter DNA and 4 to 5.5 milligrams per liter PI. So you directly add the DNA to the culture without any pre-incubation with a PI, shake it for 10 minutes in an incubator to mix it, and then you directly add the PI and that's it. Then you cultivate the cells at 37 degrees at 4% CO2, and 2 to 4 hours after transfection, you dilute the culture with the same volume with MEXi cultivation medium. That means if you want to produce protein in a 1 liter scale, you only have to transfect 500 milliliters, and therefore you need 0.75 milligrams per liter DNA for transfection. Then you cultivate the cells, and once the cells reach a viability of 75%, you harvest the cells by centrifugation and take the supernatant with your protein of interest. And then you add the biolog solution to block the biotin. You need 1 milliliter, which costs around about €2, to block the biotin in 1 liter of the MEXi media. And you add 10% of tenfold buffer V in order to prepare the supernatant perfectly for the downstream process. And then you apply the supernatant to a Strep-Tactin XT column. If you have large amounts of supernatant and you don't have an active system in place, you can use our wet fret device, which allows you to automatically apply large volumes of supernatant, and the columns cannot run dry, so you can keep it overnight, and the next day you can go on with the purification from your column. But finally, let's come to the summary of this webinar. We see that MEXi is an affordable expression system matched to Strep-Tag purification. The media costs €75 per liter, so quite affordable. And the MEXi system is balanced with other IBA downstream and analytic products. We have a low biotin concentration in the media, makes the Strep-Tag purification more cost-efficient because we need only very small amounts of biolog solution, and we can elute under native conditions. There's no need to optimize the purification because it's based on the Strep-Tag, and the purity that we achieve is usually higher than 95% because of this effective Strep-Tag purification. Very important, it's a completely license-free expression system. So you can use it to produce your protein for research and commercial use, which means if you want to sell the protein you've expressed, you don't have to think about any license fees that make systems very expensive. You can pay license fees for more than €10,000 or much more if you want to use a commercial system for a commercial use. Last but not least, you can use the same material for the production of all proteins because the purification process is not dependent on the protein's properties. It is based on the Strep-Tag properties. So, and with this, I come to the end of this webinar presentation. If you need further information, you can contact our technical support. And I have a final poll. I would like to know which factor is the most important one for choosing an expression system in your lab. Is it the cost per milligram protein, the yield, the time to protein, so how much time do you need before you have finally your purified protein? Are there IP issues like cost for license fees and personal experience with the system? So here we can see that cost per milligram protein is a minor issue. Most important are the yields. Then there is a time to protein. IP issues are no problem for the audiences, and personal experience with the system is as important as the three other facts. Thank you very much.